Do you want to learn how to take your ebooks to the next level? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a flipbook from a PDF using Canva. Let's get started. Now, if you're not familiar with a flipbook, essentially what it is a book where the pages actually flip. Sometimes it's referred to as an interactive PDF, flipbook, flippable pages. Whatever you want to call it, it just takes your PDF or your ebook to another level. So let me show you how simple it is to create it. The first thing we're going to do is head over to Canva. Now you'll notice my screen might look a bit different from yours if you're using Canva because I am using the new glow up feature from Canva. So don't worry about it. I'll show you exactly how to get to the information you're going to need. So the first thing you're going to do is head to the section on your Canva screen that says apps. You're going to click on that, and then where it says search apps, what I want you to do is to type in the word flipbook. So once we do that, you're going to see a number of different options presented to you. I want you to go to the center of your screen or wherever it appears and look for Heyzine flipbooks. We're going to click on that because we're going to use Heyzine to create our flipbook. Because I already have an ebook created, I'm going to click on the option that says use in an existing design. So I'll click on that, and then I'm going to need to tell Heyzine where to find this within Canva. So I'll go to the section that says your projects, and then I will click on my PDF. What that's going to do is open it up, and you'll notice that it gives me the option of asking me which pages I want to use. So if I wanted to deselect a page, I could, let's say, scroll down and quickly deselect it, click done, and be ready to go. For purposes of this tutorial, I want to use all of the pages. So I'm going to just leave everything checked and then click on done and then save it. What it's going to do is now prepare my design, and then it's going to move it over into Heyzine. So all I have to do is to click on this section here that says view in Heyzine flipbooks. And once I do so, it's going to open everything up for me. Now you'll notice that it has opened it up, and it gives me the option of either registering or just working on it as is, and then I could register later on if I choose to, or not register at all. I'm going to click on close, and now what I want to do is to begin the process of showing you what this looks like, because it looks amazing once it moves over. So if I use this little arrow down at the bottom here, if I click on that, you'll see the pages actually flip like a magazine. And so that right there is pretty cool. But there's so much more you can do with Heyzine. So I'm going to go back to the beginning, and you might be able to hear that it does make a sound as well, but you can also silence that. If you don't want the sound, you can always come up to this little icon and click on it and turn the sound off. Now let's go ahead and go through some of the options that are available within Heyzine. So over on the left side, the first thing I want to show you is the title. So if we click on that, we can actually put in a title for our ebook. Once you have the title in, you'll notice that you have a few options here. So I can choose to show it on the flipbook background, which is what you see here, or I could turn that off. So I'm going to save it right now so you can see what it looks like. If you don't like that style, just go back to it, click on title again, and toggle that off and make sure to click save. The next thing you can do is to decide on the type of page effects that you want. What you saw previously was the magazine effect, but if I click here where it says page effect, I have a variety of options that I can get to by clicking on this drop-down menu. So when I click on that, let's say for example I were to select book. Now if I click on book and close, you'll notice it's changed the way that the PDF actually appears here, and the pages are going to flip more so like they would if you were turning the pages of a book. So that's another option. And then I want to show you one other. Let's go over and select notebook, and you'll notice there that it has changed the style of the PDF again to look more like an actual notebook. And the same thing, the pages are going to flip. But I'm going to go back to page effect and just leave this set to magazine. And again, you have the options of deciding whether or not you want the sound on or off. I'm just going to leave it as it is and then click close. The next section under this panel is background. So if I click on that, I can change this section by clicking on the options that are available. And they do have quite a number of options available, but in addition to that, you can also click on the cloud icon and upload your own. I'm going to just go back and select, let's go ahead and select this one, and that allows it to stand out a bit. So I'm gonna then click on close. And so now that has been selected. Now the logo would allow you to remove the Heyzine logo and put in your own logo. Now the only way you can do that is by upgrading it. And I'll show you in just a second the pricing so that you can see it is very inexpensive to actually upgrade. So the next thing we can do is go down to where it says controls. And this is going to allow you to zoom in, zoom out. You can change the style of the icons that appear here and the other navigation items and so forth. The next thing is if you want to add in a table of contents, which could be really helpful for your readers, you can change this from disable to show page thumbnails. And once I do that, you'll notice on the right side of my screen that the pages are showing up here. And by clicking on those, I can easily get to them. So that could be helpful for your reader as well. Once again, I'm going to just leave that turned off. And then the next thing is if you want to have audio, you have the opportunity to upload audio to your books. I don't typically do that, so I'm going to just close this out. And then the next thing that you should look for is the section that says Password Protect. Now it's up to you if you want to do that, but if you did want to do so, you could actually put in a password, and I would probably suggest putting in one password for everyone as opposed to one password per user. But once again, it depends on the type of ebook that you have. So if you were to click on one password for everyone, you would type in the password and then you would put the text in that would prompt people to enter the password. The next thing is if you wanted to add a capture lead form. Now this is once again an upgrade. So this might be something if you're using this as a lead magnet that you could actually do that. And then if you want to change out the PDF altogether, you can click here to replace it. Now there are some other options that I want to show you. So let's go down to this section where it says interactions and we're going to enter edit mode. So the first thing it says is link. And that is if you want to add a link to an exterior page, an exterior website, you know, a video, podcast, whatever it is. So you would click on link, for example, and then what I would need to do is to select an area in the page, and then I would, you'll probably see that little cross show up. And so then what I would do is highlight it by clicking and dragging. And then what I would do is indicate what action I want to have once they click this link. If I were to click on that, then I could put in, for example, my YouTube page. So let's just put that in so you can see how this is going to work. Now, once you enter in your URL, then the next thing you might want to do is to indicate whether or not you wanted to open in another tab, which I would, so I would click on that, and then I also would want to highlight this on page turn, and you'll see what that means in just a second. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that on as well, and then click close. And then to see it in action, you need to come back to the section and stop the editing process. So you just click on that. Now what happens is when I turn the page, let me go back and show you. So now when I turn the page, you'll actually see that if I were to click on that, it will take you to my YouTube channel. All right, so that just shows you that that does in fact work. Now, another thing you might want to do, which could be a really good option, is let's say you have a video that you would like to display and have people watch within your interactive PDF or your flippable book. So let's get to a page and now let's put in a video. So once again, I would click on video. And then what I have to do is to draw the section where I want the video to appear. So let's put it in here. And then what I would do is to put in a video, for example, that I would want people to watch. So I'm just going to paste that in. And for player options, again, you can select what you want to happen. So let's go ahead and say highlight the action on page turn. I don't want the video to play automatically, and I don't necessarily want it set to be muted. So now I'm just going to close, stop the editing again, and then if you'll notice, let's go back and let's turn the page, and you'll notice that it kind of flashes to draw the attention to the individual. So if I were to click on that, people can then watch your video while they're still within your ebook. Now that's something that that might be worth doing it, simply because you really have a difficult time doing that with just a standard ebook that you would create within Canva. All right, now if you ever decide you want to get rid of something, then you would just click on edit mode. And let's say, for example, I wanted to get rid of this video. Then what I could do is just come up, click on the trash can to remove it, and now it's gone. To put it back, remember, all you do is highlight the section, paste in the video, go to the player option, select what you want, and click close, stop the editing. All right, now the last thing that I want to do is to show you, in order to be able to use all of the features that we've talked about, I just want to show you how inexpensive Heyzine actually is. So here's your options. So for their free plan, you can create 5 free flipbooks with unlimited pages, no ads, you have a gig of storage, you can use the password protection feature, but you are going to have the Heyzine logo show up. If in fact you decide you want to go to the next level, then you can, it's simply like $4 a month at the time of this recording. You can do unlimited flipbooks. You won't have the watermark, which would be the Heyzine logo. You can actually upload your own. You have 10 gigs of storage. So it's very inexpensive for all of the things that are available to you. So definitely something to consider if you're going to be creating flippable ebooks. So now let's go back to our book here, and I want to remind you that anytime you make any type of changes, you want to always make sure you click on save. So that way, everything that you've changed is going to be saved. And once you save it, now what you can do is click on share. Once you click on share, it's going to give you the link that you would provide to the individuals that want to read your ebook. And so to do so, you would just copy this, and then this is what you would send out to them via email or however you're distributing your ebook link. But just to show you that it works, if I were to open up another tab and paste that in, it will actually go to my ebook. And I can click on it, and you'll notice that this is where I clicked and put in a link to a domain, and it will actually take you there. All right, the next thing is, let's go to the page where I put in the link to the video. If I were to click on that, I have it muted, it's actually going to play right within the ebook. So now that you've created your flipbook and it looks amazing, the next thing you want to do is to make sure you know how to sell it. I want to recommend a platform to you that I think is pretty awesome, particularly if you're just getting started. You want to click on this link to watch the video where I'm going to teach you how to sell digital products online using System.io. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.